my book, The Defense of Paradise, is mainly about a 15-year-old boy who survives the apocalypse, or what he thinks is the apocalypse, and lives together with a small group of people in the Alps, in the Bavarian Alps. He's very smart, very intelligent, and he's a very good writer with just 15 years old. But in the new environment where he lives, where it's all about how to survive and how to grow plants and how to grow animals, he's completely useless because he just has his imagination. So it's mainly about this boy, and then all of a sudden it turns out that the group has to leave the Alps and go to France. Since the novel is set in the future, I thought I couldn't use the language we speak today. And so on the one hand, it was a challenge, and on the other hand, it was fun for me to invent kind of a new language, which is not a new language. There are just a lot of English words and words from other languages adapted into German in the original book. Why I picked this particular group of people is that they are kind of representing different characters from society. Kind of an idea what would happen to the group, but how they... Well, you have to imagine it like a building. I know the structure of the building, but I don't know the different rooms inside and what they look like and how I furnish them. And so the group was similar to that. In the end, it's a book that asks the question that every writer asks himself: why am I writing? What use is it that I sit here and write for years, and who will ever read what I'm writing? So he kind of reflects not only my role, but the role of all the writers or artists. I think that's a very topical and important question today: what role art plays if the world is about collapse, about to collapse. It's not that bad right now, but it might be in the future. And then you ask yourself, okay, why am I sitting here? Why am I writing a fictional novel? And why am I not out there and try to change things?